was in a very dangerous bar in downtown Atlanta where I was cruising for females, and they were playing there. The thing that caught me first was Ronnie. I hated him, and I liked him at the same time. He aroused something in me as a spectator watching a band. So this guy is weird, you know. Like the way he ended songs, the way he used his hands to end the song. I don't know if I like that. Or then I said, yeah, that is kind of cool, you know, like that. He got me into it first before anything else. I just couldn't take my eyes off him. He was so unusual. Just never saw anybody like that. He was a very weird front man. The first night I heard him, they were playing Freebird. And no one was paying any attention, you know, including me. The thing that got me, the song that really pulled me in was I Ain't the One. That killed me, still does. I've never gotten sick of that. The opening lick and just how tough it is. It's a great heavy metal tune. And that's the thing that really got me. That's the tune I signed him on, I would say.
Robert Nix of the Atlanta Rhythm Section.
Al Cooper Salt and Lynyrd Skynyrd, what they were. That was nobody did. Al deserves a lot of credit for that, you know? He brought him out to the studio, man. The studio kind of spent his own money on him. And he knew they had it, you know? A lot of people, a whole lot of people, don't give Al credit for what he deserves. But I'm going to tell you what, I'll give him credit for it because I was there. I saw everything that ever happened. He deserved every bit of credit he gets. He deserves it, you know? You tell him I said so, okay?
I'll tell you what, man, I'm going to do better than that. I'm going to put what you just said in the show.
And so Al brought those guys out to the studio. And he says, hey, Robert, I got a group of you here from Jacksonville. And I'm going to tell you what, I said to him, when those guys started saying, I said, hey, they're better with a haircut of yellow. What you trying to do? I said, Al Cooper, you have got you a hit group on your hands, old buddy.
Again? Al Cooper.
Jimmy Johnson, producer from Muscle Shoals, heard them in another form entirely, other personnel, another drummer and I think another bass player, and recorded them probably 8 months prior to my hearing them.